Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Decimals Part 6, and in this video, we will be learning how to subtract decimals. All right, the principle you use to add decimals will be used to subtract decimals as well. So we basically are going to line up the decimal points. So let's take an example. Let's say you had 17.34, which is 17 and 34 hundredths, minus 5 and 9 hundredths. This could be thought of as $17.34 minus $5.09. We're going to line up our decimals. So we have 17.34 minus 5.09, and we're going to write the decimal down here and just do our regular subtraction. Right, so there's all sorts of different ways of subtracting, but let's see what we're going to get. We're going to get $12.25, or 12.25. So that's our answer to this problem. Okay, so here's one for you to try. Do 134.9 minus 52.7. Okay, try that problem. Okay, we just line up the decimals, right? So we're going to do it over here on the side. 134.9 minus 52.7. And lining up the decimals, we're going to have to put the decimal down here. We've got 82. So those are our two answers. Don't know why that two looks so funny. Sorry about that. Right, now here's a tricky one. Let's say you've got $10 and you're going to give away $2.50. Can you figure out how much money you'd have in your head? You'd have $7.50. How does this lining up the decimal points go here? Well, you have 10, and remember there's always a decimal point after it, the whole number, and then you've got to line up 250. Now here's a common mistake that people make. They subtract over here and get 8, and then they get 50. And that's the wrong answer. Hopefully you know the answer here is $7.50. Or 7.50. Here's the trick. You must add zeros up here, append it after the decimal point. You need to have the same number of digits showing up on the top number here to do your subtraction. And now you can go ahead and subtract. Now, usually you're not going to have these extra zeros here, but I was thinking in terms of money, and that's why we're doing it this way for this first problem. So if we subtract, let's see, 0 minus 0 is 0. Can't do 0 minus 5, so let's say I could borrow, and that's going to give you 9, right? So 10 minus 5 is 5, and that's 750, which is the correct answer. So the trick is make sure you put extra zeros if necessary. That's the hardest part about subtraction is when people forget to do this. Very common mistake. Let's do another one. How about if I had 8.1 minus 3.5? 527. Okay, so we're going to take the 8.1 and subtract 3.527. Again, the key is to putting the extra zeros up here. You need to make sure if the bottom number has three places after the decimal point, you see three digits in the top number after the decimal point. And now you can go ahead and subtract using any method you use for subtraction. So let's see. There's one method. I'll just do the regular way most people learn how to subtract. Let's see if I borrow from that. That's at zero. And I can get 10 here. Then I have to borrow from that to get a 10 here. Okay, so 10 minus 7 is 3. 9 minus 2 is 7. Now I can't do 5 minus 0, so I got to borrow from that. So 10 minus 5 is 5, and 7 minus 3 is 4. So the answer to this problem looks like will be 4.573. Now, it's easier to make mistakes in subtraction than it is in addition. So the way to check your answer is you just add your answer to what you subtracted and you should get back to where you began. So let's check this. So the question is 4.573 plus the 3.527. We want to know if that adds up to the 8.1. So let's go ahead and do that. So 3 and 7 is 10, carry the 1. 10, carry the 1. 11, carry the 1. 8.100, that's the same thing as 8.1. So it checks out. So that tells me this is the correct answer. And I suggest you check your subtraction that way. Go ahead and go back and do it. Much easier to make mistakes. Also, there's a lot of easier ways to subtract than with all this borrowing, and that's on other videos of mine you can look at. Easy ways to do subtraction. There's several ways that people use to subtract, but basically, it's as if you're doing 8100 minus 3527. It's just that you've got that decimal point here. All right, so try this problem. Actually, I meant to put 352. Sorry. So we're doing 234.18 minus 121.352. So go ahead and try that problem, do the subtraction, and then check your answer. Okay, so let's line up. So we have 234.18 minus 121.352. And we want to remember to put that little extra zero here. Okay, now we go ahead and do your regular subtraction. Now, when you do subtraction, you could just ignore the decimal point, but you just got to put it down here for your answer. So, however you do your regular subtraction, go ahead and do it. I know everybody does it a little bit differently. So, let's see, we could borrow and let's see, that's 8, that's 2. Let's say I gotta borrow from that. That's an 8. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. 1. So it looks like the answer is 112.828. Okay. Let's check it. Because look it, I said check your answer. And how do you check it? You take your answer plus the number you were subtracting, and you want to get back to this. So we're going to take the 112.828, add it to the 121.352, and see what we get. So now this gets you practice with adding with decimals. So you have 10, 8, 11, 4, 3, 2. All right, which is 234.18, and that was the original number up here. So it checks. So that's all there is to subtracting with decimals. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.